Okay, we're going to look at factor by grouping. So this is the second part of factoring. So we've already talked about the GCF. Now, if I were to tell you x squared times a plus 9 times a, I know that a looks kind of bad because it looks like a 9, so I'm making it cursive-y. What would you say the greatest common factor is of this binomial expression? Do they have anything in common? A. So if we were to factor out the A, what would be left? Right? Is that right? That would be equivalent. Okay, now what I'm going to tell you, and we'll read over this in just a second, I'm going to tell you that A is actually equal to X plus 7. Okay? You see how they have x plus 7 in common. Just the same way we factored out the a, now we're going to factor out the binomial that they have in common. So if I factor out x plus 7, that was the same thing as factoring out the a. What's left now from here? Yes. So this is what's called factoring out the greatest binomial factor. Okay. Since they both have x plus 7 in common, we factored that whole thing out. Do you see that that's the same thing as factoring out A? Okay. So when factoring a four-term polynomial, we don't have a special name for four-term polynomial. One term is called a monomial, two terms is called a three terms is called a trinomial. Four terms is called a, no, it's just called a polynomial. Okay, with four terms. That's it. It doesn't have a special name. So when we're factoring a four-term polynomial, we're going to use this technique called factor by grouping. Okay, the very first thing we're getting ready to do before we get to doing all of this is looking at this binomial. Looking for the binomial that they have in common and factoring that out. So when later on when we get to the four terms, right now we don't have four terms. This is really like two terms times two terms. Well, anyway. Okay. We're going to be factoring out the greatest common factor from all the terms. That's always going to be our number one rule of factoring. We just learned about factoring out the greatest common factor. So what we're going to want to always do from now on when we start factoring is we always, always, always first want to look for the GCF and factor that out. That's going to make it easier. Then we're going to be grouping the four terms into two groups. And again, I'm going to show you this on the next page. And then we're going to factor the GCF from each group, factor the common binomial. So right here, what we're up to is this ex the expressions below are not ones we typically see. They're actually half factored and half expanded. But as a warm-up for factoring by grouping, we're going to factor out the expression of the form a plus b in each. So we're factoring out their greatest binomial factor. So here, the GCF is x plus 7. What is the GCF of the one below this? Y plus 2. So y plus 2 is going to get factored out. Y plus 2 gets factored out in front. What would be left behind? Y plus 1. Yes. Where do you get that 1 from? Yeah, it's right here. You're right. It's invisible. It's like, what? It's right there. Just like you all walk around with a 1 in front of you, but we don't see it. It's invisible. Right? You're multiplied by 1. So there's that 1 right here because y plus 2 divided by itself is equal to 1. And that's the 1 right there. Okay. What's the greatest common factor for the next one? T minus 4. You see, that's the one that they have in common, right? And then once you divide t minus 4 out of here, the only thing left is the t, right? And then, yes, minus 2. The t comes from here, the negative 2 comes from there. Are you seeing this? Yeah? Okay. It'll become more clear why we're doing this. Let's turn the page. Okay. So when we first look at, this is a polynomial with how many terms? Four. Does anybody know the degree of that polynomial? Three. The degree is three. How'd you get that? Yeah. The big guy decides for everyone. Now, if you look at all the terms, do they all have something in common? No. Okay, now what I don't want you to do, I don't want you to group these with parentheses because that looks like it's factored. The way I group these, so on the last page when I was reading the instructions, it says, look for a greatest common factor first. There's no greatest common factor between all of them. So what we're going to do is we're going to group them up. Now, I could rearrange and group them up, but basically, I'm just going to couple them up. I'm like, oh, you guys go well together. Usually, if you just couple them up like that. Now, the way I couple them up is I put the line. I don't like to see you put the parentheses because it gets confusing. Even though you are grouping them, if you put the parentheses, it can look like it's already factored. So don't want that, okay? So I'm grouping the first two, and now I'm gonna decide. I'm only gonna look at that binomial right there, and I'm gonna decide what's the greatest common factor between those two? X squared. So we factor out x squared. Equal sign, right? Now I'll use parentheses. What is left when I divide x squared out of those first two? Six. Does everybody see that? Okay. Now this is like a magic trick almost because the other one is going to have to match. If it doesn't match, we've done it wrong. But let's look at the next two. What's the thing that these two have in common? Now, make sure you put a plus. Plus, because you see the plus, it comes down right here. Plus four, and that's going to be an x plus six. That's a match. It's just like when you were playing that memory game when you were a kid. You were getting ready for math. You didn't know it, but even dot, connect the dots. Same thing. So now we're going to factor out the x plus six. You see that they have that in common, right? So x plus 6 comes out, what gets left behind? Yes. Now, I guarantee you, if you FOIL it, it's going to go back to the way it was. That's how you could check. You could check by FOIL, right? First, outside, inside, last. Do we need to do that? Should I show you what that looks like, or we feel pretty. Go back to chapter six, right? If you want to learn to FOIL. Okay. All right. So, should I do one more? Yeah, let me do C. I'm going to skip B. I'm going to let you guys do B. I want to do C because this is where I was telling you if it starts with a negative, factor out a negative. Okay. So, here, what's the greatest common factor of the first two? You're coupling them up. X squared. And what gets left? Yes, good. Now, here, if you don't factor out the negative, you're not going to get an exact match. Do you see why I said if it starts with a negative, the two starts with a negative. If it starts with a negative, factor out the negative. So let's make a note. Note, if it starts with a negative, factor out the negative. So, what's my greatest common factor then? Negative two. So, I'm going to divide both of those by negative two, and what's that going to give me? Okay, you see why I needed to factor out the negative, right? Because if I didn't factor out the negative, do I get a match here? I got a match. If I didn't factor out the negative, it wouldn't match exactly. It would be slightly off. The only reason why you can continue on with factoring out the binomial x plus 4 is because they're a perfect match. You see why you can continue. So what would I get left after I factor out the x plus 4? What's left? Yes. Yeah, kind of, right. So let's partner these up. Partner, partner. Okay. What's the greatest common factor here? t squared, and we get t plus 4. What's the greatest common factor between t plus 4? 1. So in essence, if I just put t plus 4, if I put the 1 here, normally you do not see that 1. Usually that's an implied 1, right? But in a way, it's kind of cool because it allows me, all I did was just factor out a 1, but it really is the same thing as that t plus 4, isn't it? So what would be, and I'm putting equal signs, line up your equal signs. Okay, what would it be if I continued to factor here? T plus 4 gets factored out, right? This is this. It factors out. And then what's left is, now do I need to put that t squared? Do I need to put that plus 1? That's the controversy we've been having. It's important, right? Because if I don't put it and I try to FOIL it out, I'm not going to get the exact same thing back. Yeah, when you add. Oh, I get what you're saying. Right. Because if you're multiplying, if I say 1x, that's the same thing as x. But x is not the same thing as x plus 1, is it? Oh, use of ones. So that is factor by grouping, you guys. Are there any others we should do? Let's, before we have you try a few, maybe let's do these multivariable. Here's a multivariable on the next page. Let's do A together. So first I group. I don't use parentheses to group. I group just because I don't want it to look factored. And a lot of times people will put the parentheses next to each other and it looks like it's multiplied. Okay, so I'm grouping. What's the greatest common factor of the first two? X. Okay, so we factor that out. 3x gets divided into both and we get 2y, right? Plus 5. What are you going to do? What's the greatest common factor of the last two? And because it starts with a negative, you want to take out a negative, okay? If it starts with a negative, bring the negative out. So then you will get 2y plus 5. Does everybody see how we got that? And then you have a match, so you have 2y plus 5 times what? 3x minus 7. Okay, you guys are rocking it. Any more that you want me to do before you try? Try, then share. Okay, finish the rest of the packet. Factor by grouping. I'll be coming around.